And welcome back to Jeff Kuehnagel live here at Citizen Studios. It's not every day where we get a superstar on our bench, folks. And when Richard Mofe Damijo, or RMD, said on social media he was coming to Nairobi, I'm telling you, it trended. And we looked for him and we searched for him. And finally, we got him on the bench. RMD, it's so good to see you, man.
Thank you, Jeff. It's so good to see you.
Welcome to Nairobi.
Thank you. Thank you. At last.
You said on social media you had passed through Nairobi many times.
Yes.
But never come in.
Never, ever come in. And I mean, this is like the appointed time.
And?
So I love it. I ate fish with my hands for lunch this afternoon with some veggies and naan bread and everything.
Nice.
Yes.
Look, for those who don't know or may not know, you have starred in hundreds of Nollywood movies. You are the face of not only Nigeria, but I would say you are the face of the continent.
Thank you. Thank
you are.
Thank you.
And you've
that.
Done so well. You put Nigeria on the map. When back then, Nollywood was, you know, a laughingstock. Were those tough days?
Well, yeah, you can say that. I mean, we were in the because we were in the process, because we were in it, thick in it. We didn't know what we were building. Our heads were buried in. We were working it, you know, working, trying to create magic. And you raise your head, suddenly people in America say, "Oh, these guys were doing surgery with forks and knives." Practically, that's what we did with Nollywood, because we had no fighting chance. Yeah. The technology was not democratized, unlike now. I mean, with a camera on your phone, you can do magic now. But then we were struggling with all kinds of things. And to have created a brand, a cinema culture, that now is mentioned in the same breath as Hollywood and Bollywood, I think we did good.
Yeah, we did good. Absolutely. And the thing is, you still enjoy doing movies.
That's my life. I mean, I live for it. It's my happy place. You know, movies are my happy place. Yeah. I'm a child of the movies, so I just love to be in the movies. You know, tell stories, tell different stories. And the good thing is, actors never retire. Mm. So you're constantly looking for the next good one. The next one is going to be the one. So we keep looking for the one until we get into our 6 feet, like I said.
When you see, like you just said, Nollywood being compared to Bollywood and Hollywood, how does that make you feel?
Very proud. Very, like I said, we created this out of nothing. You know, people were just excited to be in the creative industry and just do their thing. And it's the same thing I say for the rest of Africa. Just tell your stories. Do it how best you can. It is even better now that we're all working on a fairly level playing field. Access to capital is still a bit tricky, but I tell you, one of my biggest excitement, I was working, when I started working yesterday, I had met a lot of young people in the industry here. And I said to them, "Oh, I worked with a Kenyan in Nigeria on a movie project a few months ago. His name is Francis. I really love to see him." And everybody was like, "Oh, he's the best." You know? And that's the kind of collaborations that we want. This guy, we wouldn't let him go. He was on set. He fixed every problem that came up. And the DOP, who is a Nigerian, said, "Without this Francis, the Kenyan guy, he wouldn't do any work." Mm. You know, so that's the kind of thing, you know, with people like that here. And the guy I saw was very proud to say, "Oh, he trained me." Mm. you know, it's like a younger actor saying, "Oh, I RMD trained me." So that's what I saw yesterday. I met a guy, young cinematographer called Ishmael. You know, we're talking about Kenyan coffee and everything. And, you know, I'm just so happy. Sam, there's another guy called Sam, stocky guy that worked with us in Nigeria. Africa is being brought together, not by football anymore, you know, but by entertainment.
Yeah.
Our music and our films are constantly uniting us all. And I see a lot of redemption coming from that.
Do you also see a lot of respect for works out of Africa from the West? Are they respecting our works?
Oh, absolutely. We won't be on the same platform with them. I mean, our films are competing on the same platforms with them, streaming platforms with them, and our films are trending in some remote villages in Venezuela or Brazil or whatever, because they have access finally to streaming platforms that, you know, I've been at borders in different countries where they recognize who I am from, oh, I saw you in a plane. Mm-hmm. I was scrolling through the bouquet on BA, and I saw a movie that I thought I should watch, and you were in it, you know, that kind of thing. So yeah. It's really, I mean, the global acceptance is phenomenal. Yeah. I mean, look at the presence of Nigerians in Hollywood, in everywhere. You know, it's really very encouraging.
Yeah, we must mention why you're in Kenya. You're here to do something for Schweppes. We can mention that, it's okay.
Are you sure?
Yeah, it's okay, it's okay.
As long as they won't have to ring me like commercial time. Yes, I came to shoot a thing for Schweppes.
Yeah,
yes.
And you've been doing some stuff for Glow as well.
Oh, yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
Your face is all over this continent.
I try, Jeff. Well, my face is not in Kenya yet, well, so we have to work something out.
No. You should see the women in the gallery right now, or the women lining up to take photos.
Well, I can work with that. Well.
Does that make you proud to have been in this industry for what? Maybe three decades or so.
37
right?
years professionally. I graduated in 83, youth service 84. I've been working since 84. So yeah, I'm very happy with everything. I mean, I would like to have the kind of money Denzel has.
Or Chiwetel Ejiofor.
Or Chiwetel, yeah, my man. So, but you know. All things considered, we get by.
Yeah. And the thing is, at the end of the day, you don't have to star in a Hollywood movie, or maybe to get money, but you don't have to be on that big stage. We have our own stage here, don't
we? That's right, we do. Like I said earlier, you know, what has happened with movies or with music is the fact that technology has shrunk the world. So it doesn't matter where you shot the film, whether it's in Mombasa or it's in Lagos or at Najegunle, if it's good enough and it gets onto a platform, even if it doesn't get onto a major platform, put it on YouTube. The world, the entire world gets to see it. I mean, YouTube is, there are young girls in Nigeria who do comedy, who do skits, you know, and post on YouTube, and they're getting paid. I mean, I've never met her. I used to think that she was Kenyan. There's this girl that they say she's Ugandan.
Right.
She does skits, you know, she talks about marriages and everything. Uh-huh. You know, I met her on YouTube.
Kansime, or was it Kansime?
Yeah. I would love to meet her, shake her hand, or give her a hug, you know. So I like what technology has done for our craft. Yeah. It has really, you can be in Nigeria and dance to tunes made by South Africans or Kenyans or Ugandan, you know. So it's really, technology for me, it's the thing to thank, you know, the tech people. I mean, look at how technology has made payments easy here. Yeah. I hear of M-Pesa or something like that.
M-Pesa.
Yes. Yeah, you know, so with tech, everything is just getting, you know, the world is a real global village right
and now. And Africa's right in the middle, in the center of it, right?
Unexplored, the last frontier. Because it's a reverse now. I mean, life started supposedly from Africa and it has gone full circle and it's back to Africa.
Yeah.
And so, you know, it's for us to be able to change the narrative and show the way, and maybe through us we can find humanity again, humanity can find itself again, and we can all begin to heal and love again.
Absolutely. Look, you trained as a lawyer, right?
Yes.
But you started acting. did you ever practice? Did you ever?
So here's the thing about law. I did law only after I had become an actor. Mm-hmm. Yes, so with law, people find in Africa, if you don't litigate, if you're not wearing your wig and gown and talking in court 24/7, they don't see you as practicing.
Right.
So I did a lot of work. I bought and represented people in contents. I still do lots of what they call the round table.
Mm-hmm.
So I do opinions as well, but mostly on intellectual property side of the law.
Yeah.
Right now I'm doing a program with a friend of mine who is also a lawyer. It's called Big Wig. The idea of it is to let young lawyers who are into corporate law, into entertainment law, into all kinds of law, or real estate, or even cyber crime and all of that. The law is so wide now that you don't have to go to court these days to be called a lawyer or to be a practicing lawyer.
Right.
So there are many practicing lawyers in Nigeria today who we call big wigs, who are not, you won't see them in court, but they are making the best and biggest decisions that are, you know, influencing your lives.
Behind the scenes. Finally, RMD, advice for young actors and actresses out there, people who want to be you when they grow up, what do you tell them?
People who want to be bigger than me when they grow up. is to read, I say that because it's like the foundation. If you know that this is the work you want to do, then you must first and foremost expand your knowledge. You have to be able to key into everything. It's, the actor's life is about pictures, it's about visuals or communicating with voice. So voice and pictures, and the richer they are, the richer your mind is, the more images you can communicate, the better images you can communicate. So for me, I always say, look, first and foremost, find out who you are. Read, expand your knowledge. When you do that, you'll be amazed how better of an actor you can be. I always tell people, my being a lawyer or being a politician or a mass communicator at some point, they all enrich my craft because I can draw from everywhere. And the more worlds I have to draw from, the better I am as an actor.
Absolutely. RMD, Richard Mofe Damijo, folks, this guy is the face of Africa, if I ever saw one. Thank Everywhere you. I go, I see your face, man.
Thank you, Jeff.
And I feel proud
Thank
to
you.
Call you my brother.
Way back, from the late 80s, man.
Oh, God, give me some love now.
Thank you, man.
Good to see you, man.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. We're going to take a quick break, folks. Jeff Kanagi, I tell you, you can't make this stuff up. RMD in the house.
Thank you, man.
Oh, brother. We are blessed.
Thank you. Oh. I like that.
Oh, God. Take a break. We'll be back in a moment. That was a quick break. Richard Mofe Damijo, what a guy. What a show. Let's get some feedback. There must be some feedback, actually, if I'm getting along. Steve Nyabwa says, RMD should say hello to his wife. Oh, goodness. Louisa Kinjo says, can't believe RMD is on JK Live. That's right. Welcome to Nairobi. Welcome to JK Live. More tweets, thick and fast. Tony ED says, the most memorable movie of Richard Mofe Damijo is one a girl turned into a dog. Okay. I was 10 years old and very scared, by the way. Now I'm 30. He really is an icon. Absolutely. At 61 years old. Imagine. Looks great. 37 years in the business. Uzeltol. Oh, is that your name? Uzel? Really? I first watched Mofe Damijo on my first Niger movie, The Price. I have never cried in my life. Still my all-time favorite. One more. More tweets. Thick and fast. Slick X says, I'm an aspiring actor, screenwriter, and filmmaker, and I have to say Richard Mofe Damijo is one of the people that inspired me to act. I'm a big fan of Nollywood, and this man, Richard, is an icon. Very intelligent. Love his movies. Absolutely. Fantastic stuff. Thank you so much for staying this late to watch JKL. Remember, every Wednesday, it's all about those three letters on the keyboard that follow each other. Thanks so much. We'll see you next week. Good night.